हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय चैनल कॉस्मोपॉलिटन एजुकेशन. वी हैव स्टार्टेड द चैप्टर हेरिडिटी इन विच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड फ्यू टॉपिक्स. वी हैव कवर्ड मोनोहाइब्रिड क्रॉस. वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट द कंट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ द साइंटिस्ट ग्रेगर मेंडल. वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट द कैरेक्टर्स. वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट द traits. We have talked that what are the differences between traits and characters. These things we have covered. So in today's video, I am actually going to focus on dihybrid cross. In the previous video, I covered monohybrid cross. In that, I simply told you that mono means one, single, and hybrid means that it is going to, you know, it is going to be fused with another one. Here I have written the term dihybrid cross. Di means two. This dye is for two, and hybrid, that means it also going to fuse with another thing. Okay, and cross, yes, of course. So as in the case of monohybrid cross, we took only one character at a time. As for example, I taken stem height, that was tall and dwarf. So here, as we are talking about dihybrid cross, that simply means we have to take two characters at a time. We will be talking about two different characters in a single cross. Okay, so the two characters which I have taken here, first one is seed shape, the second one is seed color. If we are talking about seed shape, we have two different types of traits. These are two characters. For every character, we are having two traits. Okay, so for seed shape, we are having two traits, round and wrinkled. The seed shape can be round, it can be wrinkled, and this one is recessive, this one is dominant. So I have already told you that we will use the initials of the recessive trait as the symbols. So capital R for round and small r for wrinkled. Okay, the same initial will be written in small letters here for recessive trait. In the same way, for seed color, we have two traits, yellow and green. Yellow is dominant, so that's why we have used the symbol capital Y. And for green color, which is recessive, we will be using small y. Okay, so I think up to here all things are clear. So now let's start our cross, because we are doing dihybrid cross here. So first of all, we have to choose the parents, the plants which are present as parents, which will start the cross actually. So what we will be writing here, as we are taking two characters, so we will take the dominant traits of both the characters. This is yellow, this is round. So we will be taking RRYY. These both are dominant traits, and the another parent will be small r, small y. So this will be simply round and yellow. That means the plant is having round seed with yellow color, and here the plant is having wrinkled seed with green color. Okay, so these are the parents. As they will be crossing, first of all they will form the gametes. Okay, so two gametes. First gamete is capital R, capital Y, which we have got from here. The second one is small r, small y, which we have got from the second parent. They are going to fuse and they will form this plant, RRYY. So here again, let me tell you that this capital R and small r, if they are present together, capital R and small r, in that case also only capital R will be expressive. It is going to express its trait, because this is dominant trait. So here, what will be the phenotype of this plant? Capital R, small r, capital Y, small y, the plant will be round and yellow, because the small r, its effect will be suppressed by capital R, and the effect of small y will be suppressed by capital Y. So this plant will be round yellow. Okay, so now what we have to do, we have got our F1 generation. This is F1 generation. And now it will be allowed to self cross. The same thing, the same procedure which we have followed in monohybrid cross, that will be followed here also in dihybrid cross. What will happen? It will be self crossed. That simply means it will cross with itself. Okay, so it is going to self cross. Now see, we have to understand here, we have to observe that as we have got our F1 generation, the next generation will be F2 generation. So what are the offsprings or the plants which we will be getting in F2 generation? We have separated the gametes here. We have separated the gametes here. So how we are going to write the gametes actually? See, first of all, in the case of monohybrid cross, as the case was similar, simple actually, only 4 offsprings were produced in F2 generation. But here, as we are talking about dihybrid cross, 16 offsprings will be produced in this case. So we have to draw a special, you know, a particular type of structure or square here, which will be showing all the offsprings, and as they are 16 in number, we will write the boxes, we will make the boxes for them. Okay, and we will be writing the gametes which are going to fuse. To produce the plants, small y we are writing like this. Okay, so these are different gametes which are going to make your plant. Now we have to fill the boxes. See, for this box we have 2 combinations, so we will write capital R, capital Y. In this case, we are having capital R, capital Y, but small y is present here. Here we will be writing, you have to multiply these two. See, small r, capital Y with capital R and capital Y. So we will write down this here, small r and capital R, capital Y, small y. For this box we have written. Now we have to come here in this box. So here we will be writing, these two will be multiplied here, capital R, capital R, capital Y, small y. In this box, capital R, capital R, R, small y, small y. In this box we will be writing, for this box we have to write. Okay, so in this way only you have to fill the boxes, and that is going to show you what are the genotypes and what will be the phenotypes. Once you will be practicing this thing, this is very easy to draw actually. Okay, so see, we have completed our box. We have got 16 plants in F2 generation. This is our F2 generation actually. And when we will be, you know, watching, when we will be observing what are the different phenotypes in this F2 generation, so we will get the ratio actually here, phenotype ratio. It will be 9:3:3:1. Now how we have got this ratio? As it was different in the case of monohybrid cross, it was 3:1, but here in this case we have got 9:3:3:1, because when we will be studying about the phenotypes of the plants which are produced in F2 generation, we will get the same ratio. See, as for example, this plant is round yellow. R is for round yellow. This is also round yellow. This is also round yellow. And this one also round yellow. How? Because capital R and small r both are present, so R will be expressive as it is dominant. So that's why round, and here capital Y will express itself, that is for yellow. So it is also round yellow. See this one also. This one also. This one also. But what about this one? Capital R is present, so that simply means it will be round, but this will not be yellow, this will be green. Okay, this will be your round yellow. Here again, this is round yellow. What about this one? This is your wrinkled yellow. This is also wrinkled yellow. Here again we have got round yellow. This is your round green, and this is your wrinkled yellow. Okay, and this is your wrinkled green. Okay, and this one is actually your round green. Okay, so as we are going to calculate their number, their phenotypes actually. So see, round yellow 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we have written 9 here. Round green 1, 2 and 3. So we have written here round green. And wrinkled yellow, this is also wrinkled yellow 1, 2 and wrinkled yellow and wrinkled yellow. 3 wrinkled yellow we have got. So I have written 3 here. And again wrinkled green is only 1 in number. So that's why I have written wrinkled green as 1. So this is explaining the phenotypic ratio of the dihybrid cross. This will be it is appearing complicated to you, but once when you will practice these things in the notebook, it will be very easy to understand. So I think you should try it once. Just try to draw this Punnett square at your home, and then you will be able to understand the things very easily. Okay, so we will be covering the rest of the topics in the upcoming video. Thank you for watching this one. Stay connected.